Shalom to all of you, and welcome to the Hebrew Sisters. Today we're going to share with you a fabulous word, and all our words this month begin with the second letter in the Hebrew Aleph Beit. That second letter is known as Beit. We know it in English as B. So in our last time we were together, we talked about the word Baruch, to bless. But today we're going to talk about a wonderful word, a word that we've had lots of fun with, a word that was used in the very first chapter of the Bible. So it's a pretty important word in the Hebrew language. That word is
Boker.
Boker. Let's spell that.
B-O-K-E-R. But in Hebrew, it's spelled with a bet, a kof, and a resh. So B-O-K-E-R in the English, or when we transliterate it, but in the Hebrew, it's with a bet, a kof, and a resh.
Well, you just said something really important right there. Hebrew, real Hebrew, I should say, does not have vowels. It is a consonantal language. And those of us that didn't grow up learning Hebrew, well, we need the vowels. So a group of people many years ago came up with a vowel system to help us pronounce those Hebrew words correctly. But Hebrew is a consonantal language. So when we spell words, we just use the consonants. So the word boker, the bet, the kof, and the resh spell that word. And that word, boker, means
morning.
As in the morning, the beginning of what we in America have called the day, but not in antiquity.
Right. So as we begin to look at this, in Israel, if you're going to say good morning, you say Boker Tov, good morning. But whenever we bring it into the scriptures and look at it, of course, the word means morning, but there's a whole lot more to that. As we look at the living letters, we can see that morning is the breaking of the day. You've heard that term, or it is the end of a night. And so, you know, it says early the next morning. That means when the night is just coming to a close, or the darkness is, and the light is first breaking forth. But when we look at the living letters, it means this.
Mm.
This gets interesting.
I love that. You're going to use the Paleo Hebrew now.
I am.
Here we go.
But the first, the living letters, and then I'll build to the Paleo Hebrew. The living letters mean the inner room where heaven meets earth.
Wow.
That's morning. Now, because remember, we said the definition is just as the break of the day or early the next morning. So when the darkness is just going away and the light is just coming forth, and that's what the living letters indicate. It is the inner room or the place where heaven meets earth. But then let's take it to the Paleo Hebrew. And remember, the Paleo Hebrew is that ancient form of word pictures. So instead of writing words out, they drew pictures. And the word picture of this means the breaking open of the ground with a plow which is being pulled by an ox. Now, I want you to think about this, because as that plow goes into the ground and begins to break open something that has yet to be opened up.
It was closed.
It was closed, exactly. But then think about this, that the ox that is pulling that plow is one of the four faces of Adonai that's mentioned in the book of Revelation. And so we can see here that there is a whole lot more to the word morning than just Boker Tov, good morning. So when it says in Genesis 1, as you said, that he was creating the days, And it was morning and, you know, evening and then morning. What he is saying, at least what I'm getting out of it, is that there was this ending of one thing and the beginning of something new that's breaking forth in that newness.
I love that. And it's amazing that Scripture, the Bible, tells us that actually the day, because we've kind of associated the morning with the beginning of the day.
Right.
But the Bible, the Scriptures tell us in Bereshit, Aleph, or in Genesis 1. Bereshit is a Hebrew word for the Latin word Genesis. Aleph is the letter for the number 1. So in that first chapter of the Scriptures of the Bible, it is written this way. It was evening, mm-hmm, and it was morning the first day.
That's it.
And so from the biblical way of life, the day actually begins at night when the sun sets and that dusk period happens. Mm-hmm. That is actually the beginning of the day. So morning does not necessarily mean day.
Right.
And as we look more into these words, and you're learning that Boker has many levels of meaning, that's what Hebrew does.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we invite you, if you're enjoying this, to look further into the things that Darla and I, the Hebrew sisters, get to teach you. We have a school that's all about this kind of learning, taking you into the deeper levels of the Hebrew language. Now, there's something I absolutely love about the word boker for morning. I love those letters are learning, are living letters, and I love the definition of those living letters together. An inner room where heaven and earth meet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that inner room could be right here in our hearts.
That's right.
Where all of heaven is waiting to meet with you,
mm-hmm,
where all of heaven is gathered,
mm-hmm,
because of their great love for us,
yeah,
their unconditional love, where mercies are new every morning, every boker,
mm-hmm,
his mercies are new. And his, that great prayer that Yeshua spoke, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Every morning.
An inner room where that's heaven right and earth meet.
Mm.
I want our hearts to be a place where the Lord can bring all of heaven every morning,
mm-hmm,
into the inner chambers of our heart.
That is so good. And I love that you use that reference to that scripture, that his mercies are new every morning. I think the key to that is this, that we need to step into that inner room.
Oh, yes.
As he's breaking open the newness of that day, because the old has passed away. Behold, he says, all things become new. And so when we step into that inner room, into that place that he has made and created just for you, just for him, for me with him, in that place that he wants to be intimate with us, to look at us and break forth something new for us that is different than what the day before was, or even a week before, something in our past. He wants to bring forth the new in your life, and he's bringing it forth with strength, but he's saying, step into that place with me so that you can see my mercies are new every morning for you.
So we close our teaching today by saying to you, Boker Tov. Tov is a word for good. May you have every day a good morning. For now, we say Shalom, Shalom, and we are
the Hebrew Sisters.